Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Today's video is the long-awaited nursery tour. If you've been following our channel for a while, then you know that we completely redid this room. It used to be my office when I worked from home, and it was also kind of our junk room, and it was an absolute total disaster. The walls were very ugly and messy, and we completely just renovated this entire room. There's actually multiple videos on the entire nursery reno, so I will link those above if you want to check those out. But today I am finally going to finish and show you the whole nursery tour and tell you where everything is from. This video took me forever to film, but I have to film it today because we're actually moving tomorrow. And I've yet to pack anything in Zeb's room because I knew I needed to film this video. So I have a lot to do. So I'm going to try and show you guys where everything is from in this room. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. I love it so much. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video. If you do, be sure to give it a like and subscribe if you're not subscribed. The new house we're moving to, I'm pretty much gonna just redo his exact same room there. The walls are already white, so that was like perfect. But obviously the layout of the room is a little different and it's a little bit smaller. So I don't really know how it's gonna turn out. So subscribe for when we do our fully furnished updated house tour at our new house and you guys will be able to see his room there. But for now, let's go ahead and jump into this video and I will show you guys Zeb's room. Starting over here, we have his crib. His crib is Delta Children's Furniture. It's the 4-in-1. Sebastian actually has the exact same crib. It's just in gray. Funny story, when I was pregnant with Sebastian, I wanted the white crib and it was out of stock. So I went with gray and it was totally fine. It worked out for his room. And then with Zeb, I wanted white and luckily they had it, but they were actually sold out of gray. So I thought that was funny because it worked out perfectly both times. But it is the 4-in-1, so it will actually convert all the way to a queen size bed. And actually, when we move to the new house, we're gonna convert Sebastian's to the toddler bed. So I'm nervous and excited. He's really excited for his big boy bed. But these cribs have been perfect. I love them because they're simple and sleek, but they also are like obviously functional. They do what they need to do. And it just has the solid back, which I like. It's not like ribbed or anything. It's straight across, which was one of the things I wanted the most. So I love that. And then the sheet set we actually got from Target, I think. I'll double check and link it down below. It was either Target, Walmart, or Amazon. It was somewhere like that. It was just very neutral. If you didn't know, Zeb was a surprise gender. So all along, we did this room in white thinking that this was gonna be a pink sheet and a pink pillow. We were gonna tie in some pink with the white. But he was a boy, so we couldn't do pink. And I didn't want to do blue because blue just didn't really feel like it would fit with the white. And Sebastian's room has blue and green. So I didn't really know what I wanted to do, but we decided on black and white. And it actually turned out so perfect. This is by far my favorite room I've ever designed. I'm obsessed with it. But fun fact, there's not a lot of like black and white that were just like sleek and simple like crib sheets and crib designs. So I didn't have a lot of options, but I actually really, really like the one we went with. So it's just like black and white, has little elephants, polka dots, crosses, all of that. This is the comforter that came with it. And then this pillow actually came with the recliner, which I'll show you guys in a second. But I didn't want like a white pillow in the chair, so we bought a black pillow and I just kind of keep this one in his bed. Obviously when he's big enough to roll and move and all that kind of stuff, we'll take the pillow out, but for now it's just there as decoration. And then also in his crib I have just his little lamb. This is his heartbeat animal. Oh, I pressed the button. This is his heartbeat animal from when he was in my belly. I got a hippo. If the camera angle is slightly different, that's because the camera just fell. Thank God the tripod caught it. But what I was saying is with Sebastian, we had a hippo. And when we went to see Zeb, we let Sebastian pick and he picked a lamb, which turned out absolutely perfect because it went with the black and white. So this is his heartbeat animal. And this just kind of sits in the corner of his crib. Usually it just sits like over here in the corner, but have it here, you know, for the aesthetic. And then his name sign is actually one of my favorite pieces ever. I have to still order one for Sebastian. I've wanted one since he was a baby, but we just financially couldn't afford them because they're quite expensive. But with Zeb, it was one thing that I was like adamant I was getting for his nursery since I completely did his nursery. And when we do Sebastian's big boy room at the new house, whenever I completely finish that, I'm gonna order him one as well. The only thing I wish I had done was a lighter wood because you can't really read Elijah and that kind of annoys me, but it's okay. It turned out really cute. It goes perfectly with his room. And I got this from Trendy Timber. I found them on Instagram, but they've done tons of stuff. They're like one of the originals that did these signs. And they were perfect to work with. Perfect shipping time. It took about a month to come in, but yeah, it's perfect. So I love it. It was super easy to hang. And then the last thing that's kind of on this wall is his camera. The camera is not really that exciting. Literally ordered off of Amazon. Don't need anything expensive. It was the same thing we have with Sebastian. They all link in the same app. It's just the Mobi Cam. It has two-way audio. It has video. It does night vision video. So, I mean, very simple, but it does the job. And then the only other thing that we have over here is his hamper. And his hamper is actually from Target. And it was like, I think $10. It was not expensive, but again, went perfectly with the black and white. So that is this wall. Now we'll move on to probably my favorite wall. It's a toss up between this one and the mirror, but we'll move on to this wall and we'll talk about the pictures. Okay, so this wall, we have three prints. This was exactly what I wanted on this wall, was I wanted like giant prints. Now I didn't know what I wanted initially and it was really hard to kind of decide, but my mom said that like words would be really cute and I found the Dream Big Little One and Goodnight Sleep Tight. I found those on a website from the same artist and so I was able to order both of those, and then the giraffe I thought just kind of went, which ironically the giraffe has kind of like been Zeb's thing. We let Sebastian pick out a passy for him. He picked out the Lebanon with the giraffe. So it just kind of worked out and I was like, well, I really liked the black and white giraffe. So just kind of went with that one. But I got these from All Posters. They came in like less than a week and you can go and just search for like literally any kind of print. They're all priced and sized differently. So the giraffe is actually a smaller print. So I have a white border on both of those, but on like both sides of the giraffe, but it actually worked out perfect. I told my mom initially I was gonna get like a black mat to put behind it, but she said it looked fine, so we just decided to leave it and I actually don't mind it. And then obviously the two other ones were the perfect size for the frames. The frames I got off Amazon, they literally came in a set of three, so it was perfect. So we just measured the wall, hung the frames, put the pictures in them, and they turned out perfect. And then if you watched our renovation video, then you know that we redid this. This used to be brown. It does have a little chip in it from when we moved it from, or like moved it to Portland when we lived in Oregon, but it worked out fine. The things we have on here, on the top, we have his sound machine, and that's all I have on top because when I nurse him at night, I like to put my water bottle, his passy, those kind of like his burp rack, those kind of things that I need, I put on top. So I like to keep the top super clean with just his sound machine. And then on the second shelf, we have his outlet, which I just keep there. This basket, we actually just had around the house somewhere, so I don't know where it's from. But we just keep like burp rags, passies, my wireless headphones I keep for when I'm nursing him. I put his sleep sack in here right now because normally I just leave it in the bed, but I didn't want to leave it in the bed while I was filming. So his sleep sack's in here, but this is just kind of like a universal basket. And then on the bottom, I have my pump, which I never really have to use because I do stay home with him and breastfeed him all the time. But I do have my pump, and then also his Sophie the giraffe, which we haven't opened yet, but he is starting to teethe. So that will probably be opened very soon. Sophie is my favorite. I loved it with Sebastian. Very excited to have that. The next thing on this wall is the recliner, which I actually am obsessed with. The recliner we actually got, I can't remember what the name of the website was. We literally just googled like white furniture, and recliners are expensive. And I was not willing to spend $600, $700, $800 or more on a chair. That was not happening. But I did know that things that I wanted was a separate footstool because I don't want to have to recline when I'm putting him in bed. That makes too much sound. So I knew I wanted a separate footstool that I can just kick out of the way. And then I knew I wanted a swivel and a rock. I knew I wanted both of those motions. And then I knew I wanted white. So this chair met all of those qualifications. And actually, one of the other things I really love about it is that it has these hard armrests. It was a fairly cheap chair. It was only like $200 and it's super, super light. So it's not like heavy at all. So we thought it was going to be kind of cheap. And Zach actually hates sitting in it, but it kind of doesn't really matter because obviously I nurse him to sleep every night. So I'm the one who's rocking him. So it doesn't really matter. I like the chair. And one of the reasons that I like it is because the armrests are really hard, which is great when you're like nursing a baby and it has high armrest, which also help for the support. And that's one of the things that said on the website was it was perfect for breastfeeding moms. So I love the chair. It's really cheap. I will link it down below. The pillow is just a weaved pillow from Target. Turned out perfect for this chair. I wanted something just simple, and my mom actually found this one and it was like perfect because it has kind of a pattern, but it is just like simple solid color. So we like that. This is also from Target. I really like it because it moves in different directions. So if I need to like turn it, I can. If I need to turn it away from him. If I need it while I'm nursing him, I have it. It's really easy to turn on and off. So this is just from Target. We got the one that came with a bulb. I will link it down below. I don't remember what it's called or how much it cost, but yeah. So the next things in here is the curtains and curtain rod. If you have a baby, then you know that blackout curtains are essential. So these are just literally blackout black curtains. They are like just the fairly cheap ones from Target. They're like silky, so I really like them because they're like kind of nice and soft. And then they literally like just have the big rings that open super easily. So I love this. That makes his room super dark. And then the curtain rod is actually one of my favorite things. I love the like design on the end of it. So picked that out specifically because I knew I wanted a cute curtain rod. So I like that. That's the curtains on that wall. And then on this wall is actually one of my, like I said, I can't decide if I like this wall or the picture wall better. But this wall has his mirror. I knew one of the things I wanted when we were like designing this room and kind of deciding the layout of it is above his changing table, I knew I wanted a mirror because I didn't really know what else I was going to put above his, like above it. But when I watched someone else on YouTube's video, they have a mirror above their changing table and I liked the way it looked, but she said it's also really nice because when you're like done changing them, you can like hold them up and like talk to them in the mirror and they can see themselves, and works out perfectly because Zeb loves mirrors. So this is just like one of my favorite pieces. Mirrors are expensive. I did not realize that, but this mirror was like, I think 50 or 60, but it's the perfect size for right above his changing table. So it worked out perfectly. And then his changing table is actually what we used to have in Sebastian's room. So we did not have to buy this, but it is also Delta furniture. So it literally matches the cribs. But when we got this one, we got it in white. So it actually worked out perfect for Zeb's room. And then when we bought a new dresser for Sebastian's, we went ahead and got the Delta 6 drawer instead of the Delta 3 drawer. Haven't customized this in any way. I mean, the handles and everything are literally what comes with it. I do think it would be cute to get like black knobs or something, but for now, it's very sleek and simple. And then the changing pad that I have in it is literally just a black changing pad. I got it off Amazon. And then in this corner is literally just a diaper genie, so nothing exciting. And then on this wall is also his closet, which is literally nothing exciting. It's just a closet. These hooks were actually here when we moved in, so the hooks are there. I have diapers, baby book. His onesies I have just hanging. This we actually also had with Sebastian. It's just something from Target. It was fairly cheap, but I have his blankets and things like that. His snuggle me, his sign for his monthly updates. It's just a closet, like I said, nothing exciting. The only other thing that I want to say is the letters. We actually did this with Sebastian's room when we first moved in, and it was something I knew I wanted to do with Zeb as well. So I literally just bought like the wooden letters from like, I think Walmart is where Zach got them, and he spray painted them black. And then we literally just hot glued them up. So it's just his initials, but I love that. It makes his door very unique. And yeah, so anyway, I literally just remembered that I forgot to mention his rug, which is my favorite part of the room. If you watched our renovation vlogs, then you know that Sebastian also was obsessed with the rug. Zeb's room and used to be the coldest room in the house, so we knew before we put a baby in it that we needed to have a rug to kind of like add extra warmth. So I found this rug at Lowe's. I am obsessed. It was fairly inexpensive, especially for rugs, because like if you know they can get really expensive. And this one was fairly inexpensive, and we knew that it would go if we made it the room like with pink, or if we went like with something for boy, because it kind of has like a blue hue to it, but it works with the black because the black kind of makes the blue look black, if that makes sense. But I'm actually obsessed with it, and so is Sebastian. He loves to like lay on the floor. Zeb loves to lay on the floor in his room, especially because it's black and white. I really think he likes to lay in here and like look around. So anyways, that is Zeb's nursery tour. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I will link everything down below. If I forget anything and you want to know where we got something, just send me a DM on Instagram, ask me down in the comments. I will always respond to all the comments. So just let me know. But yeah, I love his room so much, and I hope you guys did too. Be sure to like and subscribe, and we will see you in the next one. Bye!